I want to thank again the organizers for giving this chance to me. Today I am going to talk about a research on Briscoe spheres bounding homology balls. Okay, we start by fixing our notations. For us, Y means closed oriented Sumut 3 manifold and X is the compact oriented Sumut 4 manifold. This is our first definition. Y is called an integral homology sphere if it has the same integral homology of three-dimensional sphere. And the notion of an integral homology ball can be similarly defined. Here, actually, B4 is the four-dimensional ball. And since the three-dimensional sphere bounds four-dimensional ball, we naturally ask the homology and analog of this question, and which integral homology spheres bound integral homology balls. This question is addressed to Briscoe spheres because given pairwise coprime integers p, q, and r, they are always integral homology spheres. They can be defined as the links of the singularity at the origin. And it is an algebra geometric object, and you can imagine the Briscoe sphere as in the picture. A large number of Briscoe spheres are known to bound integral balls due to classical results of Akbulut and Kirby, Casson and Harrer, Stern, and Fintuschel-Stern and Fickel. These are all proved around 1980s. And this is another definition. And similarly, the four manifold X called a rational ball if it has the same rational homology of the four ball. And this is the fact gives us an integral sphere bounds an integral ball, then it bounds a rational ball as well. And the reverse direction motivates the following definition, and we call an integral sphere is said to be non-trivially bound a rational ball if it is obstructed from bounding an integral ball. Here the obstruction means you need to calculate some integral homology cobordism invariant and find it is non-trivial. Now our first question becomes as which integral spheres non-trivially bound rational balls. Fintuschel and Stern again provide the first example by showing that the Briscoe sphere sigma 237 bounds a rational ball, and they computed its Rachlin invariant and find it is non-zero. So the Briscoe sphere, this sphere, non-trivially bounds a rational ball. This observation of Fintuschel and Stern is closely related to the notion of homology cobordism groups. For us, A is an abelian group. The A homology cobordism group is defined as follows. We take an equivalence relation on the set of A homology spheres by identifying two spheres if and only if there exists a four manifold, actually a compact oriented smooth four manifold X such that our initial spheres co-bound X and the A homology of X is the same as A homology of three-dimensional cylinder. We are talking about a group, actually an abelian group. So the summation of this group is given by the connected sum. And three-dimensional sphere gives our zero element, and the inverse element can be found by taking the orientation reversal. This is another fact, and you might guess a homology sphere Y bounds an A homology ball if and only if our sphere Y is a homology coordinate to three-dimensional sphere. And this is another again fact. Since the integers is the subgroup of rationals, there is a canonical group homomorphism psi from integral homology cobordism group to rational homology cobordism group. It is natural. It is induced by inclusion. So the result of Fintuschel and Stern can be interpreted as This map is not injective because we found a non-trivial element in the kernel. Further, the kernel of psi contains a Z subgroup generated by the Briscoe sphere 237. This sphere has remained only one example for more than 30 years, and difficulty of finding such examples is due to, first of all, to handle the composition of four manifolds, because if such a sphere exists, then the corresponding rational ball necessarily contain three handles. This is the visualization problem. And the second one is the complexity of Kirby calculus, because there is no general method for finding such examples. Almost all proofs present their own originality. So the challenge gives the motivation for searching and finding such examples. And Akbulut and Larsson recently presented first additional examples. They show that the following Briscoe spheres non-trivially bound rational balls. Inspiring by their work and using their technique, we found new infinite examples. Actually, the numbers are quite similar. So in the proof, we will use the technique of Akbulut and Larsson. Now I describe what it is, and for us, let Y be denote the three manifold obtained by zero surgery on the figure eight knot in the three-dimensional sphere. As in the picture, zero denotes the zero surgery, and the knot is the figure eight knot. Akbulut and Larsson first observed that if you do one more integral surgery on Y, and you get obviously three manifold. If your three manifold is further an integral sphere, then it must be bound a rational ball. So we are ready to present our proof, but I want to first note that our Briscoe spheres are respectively the boundary of Plumb-Marron manifolds. These are the Plumbing diagrams. They can be found easily by solving Diophantine equations. It is technical, I skip this. For this, you may check the first chapter of Savalier's book, which is called Invariance of Homology Three Spheres. To complete the proof via previous lemma of Akbulut and Larsson, we use Diel approach. We will give integral surgeries from their plumbing graphs. And their corresponding surgery diagrams as follows. We attach each dark black knot and unknot, and these are the surgery diagrams. We will explicitly show that our spheres obtained by minus one surgery on the three manifold Y. And for the first family, this is the base case. In the whole picture, minus one dark black components will be blown down. And as you see, we reach the three manifold Y easily. This is the, again, base case for the second picture. Quite similar procedure happens also there. And we applying as blow down several times minus one components, dark black minus one components, we again reach the three manifold Y. And we by using the lemma of Akbulut and Larsson, we conclude that our spheres bound rational balls. This is the general scheme. For that, we also in the first passage, we again blow down the minus one unknot and get the second picture. Here you see minus two chains. So we applying blow down m minus times, we get the third picture, but the third picture is occurred in the base case. As you see, it is in the second picture. Again, you follow the same passages, you get the three manifold Y, and it is also same for the second family. Again, by using the lemma of Akbulut and Larsson, we conclude that our spheres for all n bound rational balls. For the obstruction, we need to calculate some homology cobordism invariant, actually integral homology cobordism invariant. This is the mu bar, Neumann-Zeeman invariant. For us, let X denote the Planck 4 manifold with the boundary Brisson sphere. There is a unique homology class W in the second homology, which is called Wu class, satisfying two following conditions. Here, the dot product means the intersection number. Then Neumann-Zeeman invariant for Brisson sphere can be defined as the following ratio, and our graphs, they both have n minus plus vertices. When n is even, the self-intersection of Wu class are both minus n minus 13. This calculation is so technical, anyone who knows linear algebra can do that. So again, for this, you may check the first chapter of Savelyev's book. Thus, for even n, our spheres have non-trivial Neumann-Zeeman invariant, so they do not bound integral homology balls. And this is the further direction of this work, and all well-known integral homology cobordism invariants cannot detect the linear independence of our spheres. So the first further question is that the kernel of Psi contains Z infinity subgroup. Similarly, we ask that does it contain Z infinity summand? On the other hand, we just prove that they are not integral homology cobordant to three-dimensional sphere. They may be cobordant to each other. And so this is the third question. And my last comment is that you can use our method to recover the classical results, some classical results of Akbulut and Kirby, Casson and Tarrer, Stern and Fickel very easily. For this, you can check my preprint as well. That is all I want to say. Thanks for the listening.